Hey guys, H for Bats.
Hey Henry.
We debated over how to insulate our shop, and I am going to go with full insulation, R19 in the walls. We're going to put a ceiling in and blow in some insulation, because I really want to be able to condition the space. But with a metal building, you have a lot of radiant energy that comes in, and it was very evident when we were pouring concrete. It's been evident since we've been in the building. On a nice bright sunny day, and even on a not so bright sunny day, if there's sunlight out here, the inside of the building is typically at least 20 degrees hotter than just standing outside. So when it was 106 degrees out here, it was about 120, 125 degrees out here in the middle of this shop, because with the sun on it, you're just inside of a steel oven. And we looked at several solutions. I looked at the bubble foil wrap, and I decided against the actual bubble foil wrap specifically because we are going to be going with conventional fiberglass insulation. And after talking to hopefully experts, thinking about it myself, looking at the characteristics of heat transfer and how it works, I decided that a foil shield or just a radiant barrier would be the best approach, and perforated at that to allow the moisture to equalize, because I didn't want to end up with two moisture barriers. You should have one moisture barrier and that's it. When we insulate, we're going to end up with two moisture barriers if this were not perforated. So this will let the moisture out so that we don't have a mold or any type of issue. And I don't think we'll have a problem. Now, my big deal is I am a little skeptical, obviously not almost $400 worth skeptical, but skeptical as to how much of an effect this is going to have. I've watched the videos, I understand the theory, I understand radiant energy, energy transfer, I am an engineer. But in practice, sometimes things break down, and I'm not positive what to expect, but I am going to give it a try, and we're going to coat the entire inside of the building before we come in with our studded walls and insulation. And I should know the first sunny day how effective this has been. Essentially, all I am after with this is when it is 98 degrees out here in the driveway, it's 98 degrees or no more than maybe 100 degrees inside the shop, as opposed to almost 120 because of the cooking effect that this oven has. And you can even walk up and 5-6 feet away from the metal wall, just hold your hand up, and it feels like you're feeling one of those radiant heaters that burn off of propane. And it's just heating the shop up inside. And the hope is this will take care of it. Now, I did a lot of research looking at it. There was a lot of it that's very expensive, a lot of it that's very cheap. This kind of fell in the middle. It's by Attic Foil and atticfoil.com. And I won't endorse nor say anything disparaging about them at this point, because I just, you know, it's really just going to be, does this perform like I expect it to? I will have to say that I'm pleased with the material so far, because I looked at some other foil that was available at the local home improvement store, and when I pulled it out and I tried to tear it, I could just tear it with some effort. This, I can't tear it. It behaves like Tyvek, almost, if you're familiar with Tyvek. And I mean, I'm not kidding around or anything. I'm really trying to tear it, and I can't get this to tear. I'm sure with some equipment I could. We'll start a tear here with a cut and see. See, I can tear the threads out of it, but yeah, this just isn't going to tear apart in the breeze or the wind or anything going on. Bump into it. I've actually been in an attic with some of this installed. In installed improperly, I might add. But with some of this installed, they had actually spread it across the rafters and then put the plywood decking right on top of it. There was no air gap or anything. And then they put the roof on and drove the nails through it. It had been up there for decades, I guess. There's no telling, but it certainly wasn't like this. You could just grab it somewhere and pull, and it would just come off in sheets. It looked more like aluminum foil than anything, which is kind of the impression the stuff at the home improvement store gave me. But reading the reviews and all, hopefully this will stand up and stand the test of time and do a good job for us. I'll definitely have a follow-up video after we get this installed, let you look at it, and I'll give you an opinion, because it'll be a little while before we can get the insulation in, so we'll have plenty of sunny days with just this. And I'll do some comparisons. As like I said, on the bright, hot, sunny days, we're seeing 10 degrees, 15 degrees, even 20 degree difference inside the building versus standing just outside, just from the radiant heat coming off of it. And we'll just see how it goes. If you got any questions, let me know.